So hi everyone, my name's Katfra Smith and I'm the Involvement and Engagement Lead on the Caveat Project. In this short video piece, we're going to be highlighting what it can look and feel like to work alongside health and social care researchers. So here, Sarah Carpenter tells us her experience of being involved in the Caveat Research Study, which is a project being led by researchers from the Centre of Health Services Studies at the University of Kent, with researchers from Brighton and Sussex Medical School and also researchers from the University of Surrey, with support from public members from the Opening Doors Group. Sarah Carpenter is part of the advisory group for the Caveat study, and in this video she is going to talk about what that means, why she wanted to get involved, what her contribution has looked like so far, and what her hopes are for this project. So over to you, Sarah.
Hi, I'm Sarah Carpenter and I'm involved in the Caveat project as a public advisor.
Why did you want to get involved?
So Julie, who was heading up the project, came to the Opening Doors group that I'm a part of as a public advisor. And I was just really quite captivated by the way that she spoke about it. And she seemed really positive, and everything that she talked about with public engagement felt really authentic, and I just thought it'd be really nice to work with her. And also, I'm an artist researcher, so I'm used to having to kind of explain something in an evaluation that isn't really tangible, and I know the importance of that, and putting the person's needs and whether they've been fulfilled through the project at the forefront is always difficult, because normally you're having to explain with figures and numbers and things that really don't cover something that's creative, or something like this where you're working in the voluntary sector or within the community. And then also I used to be on a steering group for a gallery called The Stone Space in Leytonstone, and I did that on a voluntary basis, and one of the women that I worked with actually was looking at volunteers for her PhD, so I found it really interesting because I hadn't ever really been in a volunteering position before. So yeah, that kind of the mechanism behind the work that goes on there is really interesting. And finally, I also am a graphic designer. So one of the things that I try to achieve is to make things like this toolkit as accessible and inclusive as possible, and not just to disseminate the information in a pretty way, but actually to get the toolkit to entice people to actually use it in the first instance. So I felt like that was something I was really keen to do from the start, was talk about how you were going to get people to use it and that kind of draw in the first place using like design.
What does it mean to be part of the advisory group for the Caveat study?
So throughout the process, we get to meet with Julie and the team and discuss what the findings have been and talk about how they've approached things, and basically give a commentary on what we as the general public — obviously we're all general public — but to give that perspective from a different side, and even throw in some ideas and things like that. But on a personal level, what it means to me is that I feel like I'm listened to and I'm heard, and that I have that kind of equality, and that I'm valued just as a person within that. And also you get to kind of look a little bit into the system that's often like a barrier for yourself. So there's that opportunity to kind of feel like you're on the other side, and that gives me hope, because I can see that people are so positive about change, and it might not feel like that when you're on the other end, on the receiving end of care or treatment, because you just can't, because of all the difficulties with resourcing and stuff. Those are the things that kind of hold it up, whereas it can feel very personal that it's people kind of creating barriers and getting in the way. So that's really kind of like good for my mental well-being, and it gives you a bit of hope.
What are your hopes for this project?
Ideally, in an ideal world, it would be that it would equal out the playing field a little bit when it comes to funding and services that can be offered by the voluntary community and social enterprise sector, so that the toolkit would give everyone the best possibility aid more equality across the border for those who may find it tricky to find the resources to actually evaluate projects. And then also it would help them to save time and money so that they can get on with their work and actually do things, more of the groundwork on the ground, if that makes sense. And also hopefully it'll bring about a more person-centered approach to the way that we measure and evaluate things and put the person, you know, in, hold the person and offer other people that voice and that opinion about the services that they're receiving. And people just to recognise the importance of the sector, because there are a lot of gaps that the voluntary sector have to fill for other organisations. And I don't think these are necessarily being highlighted right now. And in doing this, hopefully people will recognise where the needs could be met also elsewhere. Mm-hmm. And yeah, just give people the opportunity to appreciate what goes on in the sector, really.
Thank you very much, Sarah, for answering those questions for us and letting us know why you chose to get involved in this research. For those of you watching, if you would also like to find out how to get involved in research locally, please visit the Opening Doors to Research Groups web pages or the Getting Involved page on the ARC-KSS website. The links to these will be on the following closing slide. Thank you very much for watching.